Does Omaha really need to redesign a major road to downtown?
Talking about the S curve right next to Midtown Crossing.
Some drivers say the curb takes them by surprise. One reason why the city considers an overhaul. KETV News Watch 7's Amanda Crawford joins us live with this new story. Amanda?
Brandy, the way this curve is designed, the city tells me cars are only supposed to go 18 miles an hour when they come around it. Usually they're going quite a bit faster than that. The speed limit sign just past the curb says 35 miles an hour. Now, the city admits they don't see an increase in accidents here, but tonight they told me why they still might want to change it.
Even though it's been around for about 40 years, the city is looking at ways to change the S curve. That windy part of Dodge Street that turns into Douglas. Todd Fitzer, the city engineer, says drivers have just learned to slow down.
So we're really not seeing a pattern of bad things happening.
So if they're not seeing problems with the S-curve, why fix it?
And it's really so much more than just the curve. You know, I almost wish it wasn't called the S-curve because everybody thinks that's all it is.
Fitzer says the study also looks at changing one-way streets, left-hand turns, and making it safer for pedestrians. The federal government is paying for most of the study. In total, it costs about $1.2 million. Fitzer says right now is the perfect time to do it.
You've got more redevelopment going on, and so if you wait another 10 years and the whole area completely redevelops, then you can't change anything.
But before they do change anything, they have to get public input.
Now, they've got 10 different options laid out here tonight. Some leave the S-curve where it's at, some move it across Interstate 480, and some completely eliminate it.
Fitzer says even if they end up making no changes, the study will answer questions, and he says that is why it's worth it.
Actual construction wouldn't start for another 7 years at least. Right now, they're looking for feedback on those 10 different design options. To do that, you can go to KETV.com and click on this story. They're accepting feedback until December 29th. Reporting live, Amanda Crawford, KETV News Watch 7.